Welcome back to another Aleshop video. Today, we're diving into the world of thermal imaging, comparing the Guide IR-E2 and the Guide IR-E2 Plus. These two models are packed with features designed to make your work easier, whether you're inspecting buildings, PCBs, or tackling a DIY project. But which one is right for you? Let's find out. Thermal cameras let you see the world through heat. Instead of capturing visible light, they detect infrared radiation, which all objects emit based on their temperature. Here's how it works. An infrared sensor inside the camera reads this radiation and converts it into a thermal image. Warmer areas appear in bright colors, like red or yellow, while cooler areas show up in darker shades, like blue or purple. This makes it easy to spot temperature differences across surfaces. While thermal cameras are great for identifying variations, they aren't designed for precise temperature measurements. Accuracy can vary up to 10 degrees Celsius due to factors like surface reflectivity. But for practical tasks, like finding hot or cold spots, this is rarely an issue. From inspecting pipes to troubleshooting electronics, thermal cameras are a powerful and intuitive diagnostic tool. Now let's talk about the key features of the Guide IR-E2 and the E2 Plus. Both of these cameras are equipped with the same 256 by 192 IR resolution. So you're already getting clear, detailed thermal images, perfect for budget-conscious professionals, DIY enthusiasts, or those needing a straightforward solution for tasks like building inspection, leak detection, and PCB inspection. An important difference is the field of view. The E2 comes with a wide-angle field of view, making it ideal for general inspections. This allows you to cover more area in a single glance, which is useful for tasks like surveying rooms, spotting leaks, or quickly inspecting building systems. The E2 Plus, on the other hand, features a narrower field of view, which zooms in on smaller areas. This makes it better suited for tasks like inspecting components on a PCB, analyzing heat buildup in mechanical parts, or closely examining specific problem areas. Because the E2 Plus has a smaller field of view, it needs autofocus. By pressing the second trigger, the camera automatically focuses on the subject. The E2 has a fixed focus lens, so the focus cannot be changed. However, this is not necessary, because with the wide-angle lens, most distances are in focus. Only close-up images closer than 30 centimeters are not in focus with the E2. Let's take a closer look at how both cameras perform at PCB inspection. You can use a thermal camera for PCB inspection, but without a special lens, you cannot get close enough to capture enough details. For this, you need a macro lens. For both the E2 and E2 Plus, we have developed a macro lens that can get much closer. This optional accessory allows you to perform detailed close-up inspections, making it perfect for tasks like PCB analysis. First, let's compare the E2 and E2 Plus side by side without the macro lens, so you can see the level of detail you get with the standard setup. Now, let's bring in the macro lens. It's very easy to attach it to the camera. You'll notice how much more detail you can capture, highlighting fine features and small components. With the macro lens, you can come much closer than with the standard setup, letting you focus on the tiniest details. With the E2 Plus, the magnification is largest, so you see the most details. The autofocus barely functions at this close range, so it's best to focus once and fine-tune by adjusting the distance manually. The macro lens is a specialized tool, and for most general purpose applications, like building inspection or leak detection, you won't need it. However, for electronics and small object analysis, it's an excellent add-on. Let's see how both cameras perform in facility inspections, starting with a boiler inspection. Thermal cameras are excellent for identifying issues like heat loss, leaks, or potential overheating in systems. For boilers, both the E2 and E2 Plus work equally well. With the cover removed, both cameras are effective at showing finer details, though the E2 Plus offers a slightly improved view of smaller components inside. For the fuse box, the E2 Plus is the better choice if you need to clearly identify which circuit is heating up. While the E2 can handle this task as well, its lower level of detail can make it harder to pinpoint the problematic circuit at a glance. Next, let's move on to building inspection. Thermal imaging is ideal for identifying insulation issues, leaks, and airflow problems in walls or ceilings. For radiators, the E2 works just fine, as this application is broad and doesn't require extreme precision. When it comes to locating pipes, both cameras perform equally well. However, I found the E2 slightly more convenient for this task. For outdoor inspection, the E2 is overall more comfortable to use because its wider field of view allows for quicker inspections with less repositioning. Both models deliver reliable results in these scenarios. Whether you're inspecting a boiler, checking an electrical cabinet, or scanning for heat loss around windows and doors. The choice between them ultimately depends on whether you are working with close-ups where the E2 Plus shines, or with a wide-angle lens where the E2 is most convenient to use. Both the E2 and E2 Plus use the same enclosure, which has a nice touch and feel to it. These guide cameras are much cheaper than competitive models, but it's not something you feel when you have the camera in your hand. Also, the battery life is impressive compared to competing models. The 11-hour battery life allows you to perform a lot of inspections without needing to charge it in between. Let's recap. Both the E2 and E2 Plus come with some impressive shared features. A 256x192 IR resolution with the option to upscale to 512x384 for extra clarity. An 11-hour battery life, keeping you powered through long inspection sessions. A durable, high-quality enclosure that feels solid and professional. And compatibility with a macro lens for close-up PCB inspections, available as an optional accessory. Now, here is where they differ. The E2 Plus includes an autofocus feature, while the E2 doesn't. The E2 has a wider field of view, ideal for general purpose inspections, while the E2 Plus offers a narrower field of view. The E2 Plus is slightly more expensive because of its autofocus. So which one would you choose? If you're working in general inspections, the Guide IR E2 is your go-to. However, if you need more precision for detailed inspections or close-ups, the Guide IR E2 Plus is worth the additional price. Both models deliver excellent performance, so the choice ultimately depends on your specific needs. To grab your own thermal camera, visit the Elishop website for more details. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe for more helpful product comparisons. Let us know in the comments what will you use your thermal camera for. Thanks for watching.